Hey guys, Jordan Winkler here. Thank you so much for watching. So I'm out here with my brand new Springfield Armory 1911 A1. This is the mil-spec model. No frills, no fancy stuff on here. Why the 1911? Well, I currently did not have one. And also I like to party. So we'll talk more about that as this goes on. But out here today, I'm just here to make sure that a bunch of different brands of ammo work. So I'm gonna start off with some Remington UMC, which I already have loaded in these magazines. I'm also gonna be shooting some of this Sig Sauer 45 Auto, so just their ball. But I'm also gonna try some of their jacketed hollow point stuff too, because if a 1911 can run with hollow points, well, I mean, that's great, right? And some of them can't. And I'm gonna be shooting some really cheap Tula ammo as well. The steel case stuff that everybody hates and says you shouldn't run through your gun. So that's it, here we go. First up is once again gonna be the Remington UMC. So let's go ahead, load her up. All right, it's a good sign, so far so good. Second mag of Remington UMC. Something's biting my heel. All right, so far so good. I'll give you guys a look at this first DEA target I was shooting. Obviously plenty accurate, more accurate than me. So the Springfield Armory came with two Springfield Armory magazines, 7 rounders. And next up, I'm gonna load it up with the steel case. I'll go straight to the stuff that usually if an ammo is not gonna work or not work very well, it's gonna be this. Good thing about being out and doing some shooting and training with the 1911 is that the magazines don't take very long to load. So I have 5 more on the way that I just bought. But for now, I'm just gonna load up these 2 7-rounders, which the second one, apparently I'm just not strong enough to load. And then we're gonna see how this does. Typically in striker-fired or hammer-fired guns that are not 1911s, like Sig 226, the problems that I see with the Tula ammo is usually just failure to fire, like a light primer strike. But occasionally, since this is a grittier kind of material than brass, it'll bind in the magazines, especially once they get dirty. But here we go. Let's see how the Tula works in the Springfield Armory 1911. Second magazine of the Tula. All right. Pretty much just as accurate. Obviously, we're at fairly close range here, only about 10 feet or so. Next 2 magazines worth of ammo I'm gonna shoot through this thing are gonna be the Sig. First of all, I'm gonna start with the full metal jacket stuff, and then I'll go to this stuff here in a second. But the cool thing about the Sig ammo, if you don't know, first of all, Sig is fairly new to the whole ammunition thing. But the interesting thing is that they've designed their ammo so that their full metal jacket stuff, well, the jacketed hollow point counterparts shoot with a very, very similar feel. So if you've spent time shooting full metal jacket target loads of any caliber, and then you shoot some hot and heavy plus B or plus P plus self-defense loads, it can feel different. Maybe you have to hold onto the gun a little bit harder, but not with the Sig ammo. They've designed it specifically so that the carry or duty ammo or whatever you choose to call it, the hollow point, self-defense ammo, it has the same feel when you're shooting it as the full metal jacket. So let's go ahead and try the SIG. Oh, looks like I can fit one more in here. The SIG full metal jacket ammo. If you're an ammo manufacturer, it must be kind of nice to have a name as short as the three-letter SIG name, because then you can fit it all on there without having to do any abbreviations. Okay, and a very similar hole in that DEA dot number three. That's what I was shooting that time. So as a reminder, ladies and gentlemen, this is not a comprehensive ammo reliability test, or even just a straight up reliability test of the Springfield Armory 1911. I'm just out here to shoot two magazines worth of the variety of 45 ammo that I had, which is now going to be going to the SIG personal defense ammo. So this stuff is, because I know you guys might be interested, it's 230 grain V-crown jacketed hollow point. This ammo works great. The 9mm version works great in the 320. That's what we use for that 320 P320 1000 round test. We used this V-crown ammo and it functioned flawlessly in the 320. Of course, the 320 is a radically different firearm than a 1911. So you definitely want to make sure that you always try your personal defense ammo in your carry gun. Well, in all your guns, really, just to make sure it works. All right, it didn't take long to load those 2 7 rounders up of the SIG personal defense ammo. Let's go make sure it runs. Checking at hollow point, Springfield Armory mil-spec 1911. It does feel very similar to the full metal jacket. Dang, something's nipping up my legs. Trying to invade my YouTube space. Alright. Hopefully you guys were able to see that. That's right where I was shooting. And once again, the gun's doing great, as is the ammo. All right, I'm gonna load up two more magazines. I'm gonna load up one of the Tula, and I'm gonna load up one of the Remington UMC. I'm gonna shoot those last two DEA dots on there. So if that's two magazines worth on the first four dots, that would be what, 14 times four, which is, oh boy, is that 56? I don't know, maybe I did that wrong. And then another 14, because I'm going to shoot one magazine worth on the last two. So that would be, what, 70? You guys know the math. So once again, not a torture test, not a long-term reliability test by any means. Just picked up this gun. And I said I was going to load one with Tula and one with Remington UMC, but I just loaded both with the steel case Tula. I'm going to shoot those last two DEA dots. And I'm feeling pretty good about this gun so far. Obviously it shoots great and no issues there whatsoever, but as with all 1911s, the thing I'm looking for most is reliability. All right, there's one. Oh, what do you say we go ahead and do some offhand? Woo, buddy, slow down. That's more like it. I'll show you guys this target here in a second. Not my best work. All right, and I'm out. So I shot these last two DEA dots here, the 5 and the 6. I don't have any affiliation with Springfield at all. I had just read Chris Kyle's book, American Gun. He's a big fan of Springfield Armory and the 1911. And I really wanted to go with the no frills 1911, just like the one you see here. It just has the 3-dot sights. I really like that it has this sharp ledge right here. A lot of guys don't like this because it tears up your hand when you're coming over the gun to rack it. But the cool thing is this catches on anything hard. So when you're doing one hand manipulations, it works really, really well. What else? Just basic no frills. Everybody said that if I didn't get the beaver tail grip safety on here, that my hand would be getting all chewed up. It's not chewed up at all. Didn't get slide bite one time. It's amazing how proper shooting fundamentals makes that not happen. And I guess not having super fat hands. So again, just the regular safety, regular grip safety as well, and nothing extended here or flared here or any of that stuff. So again, I'm gonna shoot this through some classes, and so far I give 2 thumbs way, way up and full on rock on to the Springfield Armory mil-spec 1911 A1. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Talk to you in a future video.